Hi, I'm Mrs. Hayward, and I am the second grade teacher here at Trinity Christian School.
I am Wendy Phillips. I teach middle school English here at Trinity Christian. I have three children as well who have attended. When I first started looking into a school for my daughter to go to, academic excellence was very important to me, and Trinity offered that. I felt like they were ahead of the public schools. Their class size was small, and I felt like they really had a firm grip on what our kids would need to prepare them. A few years later, I was blessed to get a job here, and then I was able to see firsthand how rigorous the teachers are in trying to make sure that our curriculum is not only up to date, but it is above and beyond. And as teachers, I've always tried to go ahead, as well as my colleagues, to provide numerous opportunities for them to be able to excel and to learn new things and to push them to be over-prepared when they leave us here.
We have been very blessed by technology into our classroom. We have to be mindful and purposeful to use technology for the glory of God. And by that, we hear a lot about technology and maybe how it's detrimental to our children. But technology has also given our students a window to the world. When we think about the mandate in the Bible to go out into all the world, then we're able to have students research and actually see places that we're talking about, especially when we're talking about mission giving and things of that nature. They're able to actually see how the places that we're giving to are different from what we experience each and every day.
So I feel that as a teacher here at Trinity, it is our focus to go above and beyond academically, because we are called to a higher standard. We're called to God's standard. And if we have the opportunity to over-prepare our kids and have them be an excellent representative of our school, but even more importantly, of God, He can do so much more with them.
Hi, my name's Angie Taylor, and I'm a first grade teacher at Trinity Christian School. We are very blessed to be able to have the opportunity in the fall to go for professional development, and we do that as a school. The teachers go, we get different information that we can bring back and apply in our classrooms, and one of those big topics this year was serving. So we try to pick a different topic for each month and a different way to reach out and to show that faith in action. So we have out, like in our hallway outside of our class, we have a part of the wall that we've designated as our faith in action, and we talk to the children about what that looks like to give glory to God, what that looks like to have it in our heart, have it in our mind, and then what that looks like with our hands. So from heart to hands, we want them reaching out and just showing love. And we talk all the time about that's how Jesus taught, that's how Jesus wants us to interact with others, is always very lovingly for His glory. It's nice for us to be able to be out of the walls of the school, to go into the community, and to be able to say this is important to us. Yes, we go to a Christian school, but it's not just showing up in uniforms, it's not just praying before snack. Here's what our heart's about.
My name is Andrea Verselli. We have four children. We have a preschooler, a first grader, a fifth grader, and an eighth grader. Our story with Trinity is that we were here for 3.5 years, and my husband had a possible move for his career. And so with prayer and with discussion with our family, we had decided that we would step away for a year from Trinity. We stepped away and went into the public school system. What we thought was going to be, you know, a very easy, simple change for our kids really turned out to realize that we were not meant to be there. Our kids didn't feel the home and the family atmosphere that they did. Spiritually, they just, you know, that part wasn't embraced. And so by right around Christmas time, our kids had asked several times about coming back to Trinity. And when we knew that we probably weren't going to make that move, we had decided that it was absolutely necessary to come back to Trinity, that it was something that our kids needed and what we realized that my husband and I needed emotionally, spiritually, and that we truly believe that God always provides on His timing. And so we believe that around Christmas time, that was His timing to let us know that it was time to come back to the family that we truly did belong to. It was almost like we never left. It was, we were embraced, we were loved, we remembered why God brought us back here. The hugs, the loves, the emails, the texts, the Facebook messages that we received of "we're so glad you're back," just basically came full circle for us and reminded us that how it was vital that our kids were a part of this, and they have flourished, and they are, you know, they are so happy to be back. Their classmates were just welcomed them with open arms, and it was truly like, even though we were only gone one semester, it was truly like we never left.
Hi, my name is Kayla Beckermeyer, and I, this year, am the middle school math teacher. To be a good leader, students can join many different activities to help strengthen those leadership skills. One of those activities is student council. Another one of those activities is being in the musical. Students learn how to perform on the stage, but also have confidence in front of people through leadership outlets. Another one of those activities is being on sports. On a sports team, you learn how to be a leader on your team and grow and develop those skills. We also have ribbon dance at our school, where our students learn how to worship God in the outlet of dance. Each class also has the opportunity to lead a chapel. They can do this in song, in dance, and also in speaking moments. Another opportunity for students to lead is in heart song. Through heart song, they're able to sing songs that glorify the Lord, but also lead our student body in worship.
Hello, my name is Matthew Dudley, and I'm in eighth grade.
Hi, my name is Taylor Mackin, and I'm in seventh grade.
Being on student council has shown me to value how much teachers work hard every day. It gives me skills for the future so that I can work hard later. It's taught me to work really hard with responsibility so that I can be done on time and before I need to be. Student council has shown me how to change others and influence others.
Student council has taught me how to be a good leader and have younger kids look up to you, so you have to be a good example.
Hi, my name is Alyssa Stonich, and I'm an eighth grader at Trinity. On student council, I am president this year.
Hi, I'm Mabel Benig, and I'm an eighth grader, and I'm a representative on student council.
Trinity is a very good learning environment to be in, whether it be through spiritual or academic learning. The teachers here are very kind and are always willing to help you in any situation. I've been at Trinity for 11 years, and my experience here has been pretty amazing. I'll definitely miss this place as I move on to high school.
Being on student council has really helped me to grow as a leader inside and outside the classroom. I've been able to set a better example for the younger kids who really look up to the older kids here at the school. I put more effort into my work, and I'm able to appreciate all the work that goes into planning events here at Trinity.
I feel like in high school, student council will help me to lead my peers in more of a Christ-like way and be more involved with the spirit in the school.
We have loved our time at TCS, and we will carry what we have learned here, including our leadership skills, with us into our future.
I have watched some of my students change their behaviors in the classroom, also change their attitudes towards school in general, but also Trinity Christian School. They've become great leaders. They want to lead their peers in a positive way, and I've watched their leadership skills develop over time through activities we have done, through getting excited about Spirit Week, tournaments we have, running the pep rally. So I've seen students, because of the standards set for my student council members, change their attitudes and actions in the classroom.
At Trinity Christian School, we seek to equip children with the desire, discipline, and skills to pursue excellence in all that they do, applying their knowledge in creative and responsive ways to life and the world around them. We strive to give God the glory in everything, in learning, performing, playing, serving, and leading. We do it all for the glory of God.
Thank you.
Our mission at Trinity Christian School is to provide a personalized, goal-directed approach to education and to equip children with the desire, discipline, and skills to pursue excellence in all that they do with all their heart as working for the Lord. You will find that each person you meet is here for one reason, to grow His kingdom, one student at a time. From the moment you walk through our doors, you will experience the presence of God and a welcoming family atmosphere. Together with or through the partnership of parents and our local churches, we desire to nurture and grow the gifts that the Lord has given your child. Trinity Christian School provides a secure learning environment which fosters academic, spiritual, and social-emotional learning. We are committed to academic excellence from preschool through eighth grade. We incorporate the most current research-based teaching methods with leading Christian curriculum in the areas of Bible, reading, literature, language development skills, math, social studies, and science. Our certified teachers tailor instruction to focus on the entire student and provide a comprehensive, differentiated learning experience that goes beyond the core curriculum to include classes in art, music, physical education, and computers. At the middle school level, opportunities are given to students to explore their interests and develop their gifts through a variety of elective choices. In addition to our electives, students seeking additional academic experiences may choose to participate in a variety of co-curricular and extracurricular athletics and programs. Trinity Christian School exists to glorify God. All aspects of your child's education will be supported with biblical truth. Your child will receive daily Bible lessons, participate in weekly chapel services, share their faith and love of God through service projects, celebrate Christian holidays, and be surrounded by loving Christian teachers and staff who will nurture your child's spiritual growth. As a school, we strive to make sure that all children develop knowledge and understanding of Jesus so they can make the decision to enter into a personal relationship with Him. We invest greatly in each student and in our staff. We are committed to integrating faith and learning that gives each student a definite advantage in life. We are continually enhancing our programs and practices to help ensure that our students are equipped for success in every facet of life. We are very proud of our reputation with the local high schools. We receive wonderful feedback that Trinity students are known for excellence in their academics, their work ethic, their behavior, and their engagement socially. The success of graduates is indicative of the quality education that students receive at Trinity Christian School. Our combined focus of academic and biblical excellence is a unique approach to education and worthy of your investment. Well, welcome Trinity Christian families and community. Merry Christmas from staff and faculty here at TCS. Well, no doubt it's been a different kind of year for all of us, making changes, following guidelines, unfortunately canceling events and more, but one thing never changes, and that's our Savior Jesus Christ. We wanted to still give our kids the opportunity to share what Christmas is really all about and to celebrate the true meaning of our Savior. So this Christmas program, although many things are changing, we wanted to give the opportunity, even though things are a little bit different, share that Jesus Christ, that gift at Christmas, never changes. And so we're proud and excited to share this program with you today. So thank you to all the students from kindergarten through fourth grade. Thank you to all the teachers. Thank you to Mrs. Tanka for leading and directing. And thank you to so many other people behind the scenes that are making this program happen today. And with that, I'd like to open up in prayer, and then we'll enjoy a great program. Lord, thank you for the opportunity to have this Christmas program. Although it is a little different, we know that you always remain the same. Someone who we can trust, someone that we can put our faith in, and someone who is always there for us. So Lord, thank you for your gift of joy on Christmas Day. Thank you for the opportunity for these kids to share that story today and to share it to so many people through this Christmas program. So Lord, bless them as they perform and just continue to bless all of our families, the community, and our nation as we continue to celebrate you at Christmas time. And we just give this all to you in your name. Amen. These days, Christmas time is often extremely crazy and busy with so many things to do. From parties to shopping, from recitals to exams, it is easy to lose focus on the Prince of Peace that was born in Bethlehem that holy night. Today, our Christmas is not usually quiet, calm, or silent. As we read how the story unfolded, we can see that first Christmas was crazy and busy too. Thankfully, Jesus came to bring peace and hope to this chaos in our world. Please enjoy the kindergarten through fourth grade production of a crazy, busy, peaceful, holy night. Enjoy.
Christmas is music and family in town. Christmas is Snoopy and Charlie Brown.
Anticipating the snow's gonna fall. It's praying for some place to park them all. It's mom going crazy cause turkey got burned. It's saying thanks, some gift you'll return.
Christmas is caroling kids at your door. It's paper and ribbon all over the floor.
Christmas's rooftops covered in lights, the way to manger, the wonderful life.
Christmas is caring for those who've got nothing. Dropping your change in the bellringer's bucket.
Oh, not forget his math on. Not gonna an exam on Friday.
Hold on, I'll be in to help in a minute. I've gotta get these cookies in the oven. I won the cookie party last year, and these have to be even better than last year's. Okay, what can I do to help? I have about 40 seconds until this batch of cookies is done.
This is the problem. I have 15 more to do, and I just finished my study guide.
Well, sweetie, sounds like you are making good progress. Here, you need to carry the one and regroup. Hold on, I've got to get those.
Honey, I'm home.
Dad, I really need help on this.
Hey, honey, come home. How was your day?
Dad, I really need help.
Okay, my day was good, except that I have another interview for this promotion tomorrow. We have the office Christmas party coming up. Okay, honey, let's see. You need to carry the one and then regroup. Oh, son, you've got to play that correctly.
I can't find it. I just can't find it. I need my halo before we go. Hey, Mom, I can't find my halo, and we need to go, or we're going to be late. I'll be in the car.
Oh, my goodness, I almost forgot. She has a rehearsal tonight for the Christmas musical. Could you take her? I got to get these cookies ready. The cookie party is tomorrow.
Okay, I'll drop her off and get a little more shopping done. I've got a few more gifts to buy.
Ooh, while you were out, could you get a gift exchange for the... Wait, could you get a gift for the gift exchange, please? Just not a fruitcake! Keep practicing, buddy. You can get it.
Down here.
These are friendly, cool enough to decorate. Jessica, could you help me decorate these? You are so good at that.
Oh, I love decorating cookies with you. Okay, I can take a little break from studying.
Justin, do you want to help?
Okay. Success! I made it through the mall and found almost everything else we need. Yes, I even found a fruitcake!
It's Christmas, the bells are ringing.
So glad you were home. You could help decorate. Julie, how was your choir rehearsal? Are you guys ready?
Well, we will be. The wise men had a problem spreading their gifts, and the shepherds lost their sheep. But at least Mary didn't drop the baby Jesus all this time.
Miss Tink has so much more patience than I ever would have. I don't know how she does it. Jessica, did you finish your homework?
Almost. One of my problems is a survey. Could you all answer a question for me? It's easy. What is the best part of Christmas?
Well, that's an easy one.
Presents.
What?
Cookies?
No.
Decorations?
Seriously?
Okay.
Maybe someone else could answer?
Guys, listen!
Dad, what's your answer?
Hello? Guys, listen!
Well, I love Christmas. We have the chance to celebrate.
Hello, guys, listen, it's carolers, come on!
Joyful, he is
They sing some of my very favorite songs.
I know, mine too.
I love those songs.
I'm so glad they came. Hey, what happened here? What do you mean?
What happened to what?
The nativity. Everything is knocked over.
Oh man, it sure is.
I must have hit it when I was running around getting the cookies ready.
I wasn't even paying attention when I came in with all my school books.
Or maybe I hit it with the shopping bags.
I don't think any of us were paying attention. It's been crazy busy around here.
Too busy. But look at all these pieces, all different parts of a real Christmas story.
I bet it was crazy busy then too.
Mary and Joseph had to travel a long way to Bethlehem.
Even farther than we go to Grandma's house?
Yes, even farther, and they had to walk.
And Mary was expecting a baby.
And when they got there, they didn't even have a place to stay.
And what about the shepherds? They were working that day, a stinky, smelly job.
Even stinkier than Justin's shoes?
Hey, I bet those shepherds were scared out of their minds when the angels started singing. Can you even imagine?
I bet it was beautiful and loud. And crazy.
I wonder what it was really like that night in Bethlehem, the very first Christmas.
Take me back to Bethlehem. Let my heart be filled again with wonder. Oh, and wonder. Let me hear the angels sing. Flood my heart with mystery and wonder. Oh, and wonder. Take me back. Take me back again in my journey in my heart to Bethlehem. Take me back. Take me back again and my soul be filled with wonder as I journey in my heart to Bethlehem. Wise men, bring your offerings here, following your sacred star of wonder. Star of wonder. I will bring my offering, you will have my highest hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria. and everyone went to their own town to register.
So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was supposed to be married to him and was expecting a child.
While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born. She gave birth to a firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger because there was no guest room available for them.
And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified.
But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. In the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This is a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger."
Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those whom on his favor rests."
When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened which the Lord told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger.
When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told to them about this child, and all who had heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart.
The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and which had seen, and which they were just as they had been told.
After Jesus was born, wise men from the east came and asked, "Where is the one who has been born King of the Jews? We saw his star when it rose and have come to worship him." The wise men followed the star.
It stopped at the place where the child was. They saw the child, and they bowed down and worshipped him. They presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
That night in Bethlehem was possibly crazier and busier than we get here and now.
Traveling, fighting the crowds, singing, giving gifts.
Then and now.
The perfect gift was given to us that night.
Love was born that first Christmas.
Crazy and busy became peaceful and holy.
God gave us his son, Jesus, so that we can have peace even when we are busy.
Peace doesn't mean calm and quiet. That first night was calm, and it sure wasn't quiet.
The shepherds were scared, the crowds were crazy, and the angel singing was loud.
But it sure was peaceful because the Prince of Peace was born that night.
Jesus brings peace to a crazy busy world.
Because we know we are loved no matter what.
We've been given the perfect gift, Jesus.
Christmas is crazy!
Christmas is busy!
Christmas is peaceful!
Christmas is holy!
Christmas is Jesus! Crazy, crazy, peaceful, holy, crazy, crazy.
Children and their children and their children.